Prime Minister Narendra Modi has reiterated his commitment to the people of the country, saying that he and his government aim to do much more than what has already been done. In a tweet, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that what was deemed impossible for the decades by successive governments is now possible. He said that his government's unwavering commitment to public welfare has ensured outstanding results for all sections of the society. And citing BJP slogan of Modi hai to mumkin hai, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said that the party has chosen an effective slogan for the upcoming elections. In a blog post titled Agenda 2019, Modi hai to mumkin hai, Jaitley said that the Prime Minister has demonstrated during the last 5 years his indefatigability by literally working round the clock. Jaitley said, for the first time, for 5 years in a row, India has remained the fastest growing major economy in the world. The finance minister said that in these elections, India will get an opportunity to endorse Prime Minister Narendra Modi's leadership, decisiveness, integrity and performance. Listing out the government's achievements, Jaitley said that the government brought down inflation and implemented GST smoothly and brought schemes like Ayushman Bharat for the poor. He also lauded the government for providing 10% reservation to economically weaker sections in the unreserved category. Jaitley also said that during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's leadership, India demonstrated through the surgical strike of 2016 and the airstrike of 2019 against Pakistan that it was willing to adopt unconventional methods of attacking terror at the point of its origin. And for more on this, we'll go across to Mr. Ashok Tandon, senior journalist. Sir, thank you so much for speaking to Rajya Sabha Television. Sir, what's your take on Jaitley's blog, Modi hai to mumkin hai?
See, if you recall in the 2014 elections, the slogan given by the BJP and the NDA was, Ab ki baar Modi sarkar. Now, that was projected as an alternative to the 10 years of UPA rule. And it was basically thrown a challenge that this time it will be Mr. Narendra Modi who will be projected as the leader of the country. And in that context, when the elections were held, there was criticism from certain opposition parties that this slogan will never work. But if you look at the results which came out, everybody now, even today, we talk of a Modi wave which won absolute majority for a single party after decades. And therefore, the slogan, Ab ki baar Modi Sarkar, was a success. Now, after 5 years in power, this time round, the BJP and the NDA is again giving the slogan that Modi hai to mumkin hai. That means whatever has been achieved in the last 5 years is because Modi was the leader. And the Modi's leadership has projected India on the world map. Modi's leadership has shown development. Modi's leadership has shown transparency in decision-making, corruption-free government. So therefore, this time round, the NDA is again seeking a fresh mandate in the name of Modi, under the leadership of Narendra Modi.
Right.
In a way, it is also a challenge to the combined opposition. Well, if you really feel that you can challenge Mr. Narendra Modi, why don't you project a leader who can compete with Mr. Narendra Modi? So, in a way, NDA is now making this 2019 election a referendum on the leadership of Narendra Modi, the positive achievements of Narendra Modi, and the performance of Narendra Modi.
Right.
If the opposition wants to challenge him, there is a challenge. You throw up a leader and let that leader of the combined opposition challenge Mr. Narendra Modi, which
right,
apparently doesn't seem to be happening because the Mahagathbandhan is not taking any shape. So
right.
There is no leader of the combined opposition and who is challenging Mr. Narendra Modi's leadership.
And Mr. Tandon, Prime Minister Narendra Modi as an assertive leader, has the political situation changed for the voters since 2014 elections?
See, as I said earlier, 2014 election results were described by all the analysts as Modi wave. Now, as Modi wave came into power, brought Mr. Narendra Modi into power, and as Mr. Arun Jaitley has very rightly said in his blog, that relentlessly Modi has been working round the clock for the progress and overall development of the country. Now, it is for the people of the country to judge whether he has actually delivered. And therefore, Mr. Arun Jaitley has listed a series of achievements of this Narendra Modi government. And in fact, he is throwing a challenge to the opposition. If you really can contest his claim, if you can really challenge Mr. Narendra Modi, why don't you throw up a leader? And if you have a leader of the combined opposition, as BJP and NDA had in 2014. So on the non-performance of the 10 years of UPA government, Narendra Modi was thrown up as a leader. And people put faith in his leadership, and therefore the NDA BJP is now again throwing up the leadership of Narendra Modi and seeking vote in his name and in the name of his performance.
At the time when the BJP is swinging up alliances, the opposition seems to be suffering from the desertion of the leaders.
No, the alliances of NDA are intact, or rather they have also widened, because several political parties have felt that fighting the election under the banner of Narendra Modi's leadership would be more productive and fruitful. Therefore, even certain political parties with that parted ways with NDA, like AGP in Assam, they have come back to the NDA fold. A party like Shiv Sena, which was trying to, you know, criticize Narendra Modi's government, is back in the NDA fold. And even we have seen several political parties in Tamil Nadu have also come back into the NDA fold. So that shows that not only the BJP, the NDA, but even certain other political parties feel that fighting election under Narendra Modi's leadership will be more fruitful. And that is why the NDA alliances are intact, or rather have widened. Whereas, as you very rightly said, on the other hand, the UPA has in fact disintegrated. Many political parties which were part of UPA government are not with the UPA now. So therefore, they are finding it difficult not only to cobble together a front, Mahagathbandhan, but also finding a common leader. So on these two fronts, no common leader of the UPA and also no alliances. In fact, a party like BSP could openly say that we will not have alliance with Congress in any state, leave aside Uttar Pradesh. And even in, we are seeing in Bihar, certain problems are there. So opposition's failure to put up a united front against the NDA, and also the opposition's failure to put up a combined leader to challenge Narendra Modi's leadership is quite apparent in these elections.
Mr. Tandon, one more question. What about the desertion, which the latest development of the day which took place, Tom Vidakkan joining BJP?
No, see, the thing is, when political parties see the writing on the wall, similarly, many individual politicians also see the writing on the wall. And that is quite visible in states like West Bengal, where we could see a Trinamool Congress as a very cohesive party, united party under Mamata Banerjee, is now disintegrating. Similarly, we see certain developments in other states as well, and many, and the Congress also. I mean, biggest surprise of the day is Mr. Tom Vidakkan's joining BJP, the man who was a Congress spokesperson, the man who was very close to Sonia Gandhi, has also left Congress party and now joined BJP. So that shows that the political parties across the spectrum also are seeing very clear writing on the wall, and therefore desertions.
Thank you so much, Mr. Tandon, for joining us and helping us understand this very important development in detail. And moving on, as we were discussing with Mr. Tandon, in a huge embarrassment to the Congress ahead of the Lok Sabha polls, its spokesperson Tom Vidakkan, once a key aide of the UPA chairperson Sonia Gandhi, joined the BJP on Thursday and attacked his former party for its stand on Balakot airstrikes. Vidakkan, who joined the Saffron Party in the presence of the Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad and later met its president Amit Shah, said that, "I am deeply hurt and that is why I am here." Asserting that the Congress questioned the integrity of the armed forces, he said that the attack by the Pakistan on our land and the reaction from his party was sad indeed. In an apparent attack on party chief Rahul Gandhi's leadership of the Congress, he said that he gave the party 2 years of his life, but it has now resorted to a practice of use and throw. Dynastic politics has reached its zenith. in Congress, he said, adding that he believed in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's development narrative.
ये देश प्रेम की बात है. अगर कोई पॉलिटिकल पार्टी कोई ऐसा पोजीशन ले जो देश के खिलाफ है तो मेरे पास कोई और विकल्प नहीं था कि उस पार्टी को छोड़े. और आप जानते ही हैं कि क्या क्या समस्याएं हैं. लेकिन अजीब गरीब बात यह है कि ऐसे वक्त पर इस पर टिप्पणी करना सही नहीं है.
Trinamool Congress leader and four-time MLA from West Bengal, Arjun Singh, has also joined the BJP. He joined the BJP in the presence of Party General Secretary Kailash Vijayvargiya and West Bengal BJP leader Mukul Roy in the national capital.
सिर्फ एम 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 माँ माटी मानुस अब सिर्फ मनी 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 रह गई है. इस पार्टी के साथ रहना हम लोग जैसे लोग जिन्होंने वामपंथी लड़ाई हम लोग एक साथ लड़ा और वामपंथी को खत्म किया इस दिन के लिए नहीं जो दिन आज हमें देखना पड़ रहा है.
एंड द इलेक्शन कमीशन हेल्ड इट्स फर्स्ट मीटिंग विद द सेंट्रल ऑब्जर्वर्स ऑन थर्सडे एज पार्ट ऑफ द प्रिपरेशंस फॉर द अपकमिंग लोकसभा इलेक्शंस. चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर सुनील अरोड़ा, Election Commissioners Ashok Lavasa and Sunil Chandra, I beg your pardon, Sushil Chandra, along with other senior officials, briefed the central observers about their roles and responsibilities while on election duty. The meeting is the first since election dates were declared on 10th of March. Election Commission has earmarked deploying over 800 expenditure monitoring observers for the multi-phase polls, which starts on 11th of April. The observers were told about the process, code of conduct, rules, laws and other issues that they will be facing during the polls. Polling would be held over 7 phases through 19th May, followed by counting of votes on 23rd of May. The Election Commission has decided to closely monitor social media campaigns of political parties and candidates along with their print, electronic and radio advertisements. The poll panel has enlisted the cooperation of Google, Facebook and Twitter to uphold the integrity of the political campaigns on their platforms. Before posting on the social media, the candidates and the political parties will have to get a certificate from the Election Commission. The Election Commission has set up monitoring rooms to closely look at the content. The Election Commission has constituted a four-member team of social media experts who will monitor if any political advertisement is certified by the Commission or not. The team will also closely monitor any content that is aimed at vitiating conduct of elections or has the potential to disturb the social harmony. The Election Commission is also creating its Twitter handles at district levels to follow all key candidates and to keep an eye on their social media activities.
देखिए MCMC का मतलब है मीडिया सर्टिफिकेशन एंड मॉनिटरिंग कमेटी कि मीडिया में जो भी पॉलिटिकल कंटेंट आए उसका सर्टिफिकेशन पहले हो और ये कमेटीज को मॉनिटर करती है. अभी जैसे चुनाव का समय है तो ECI के ऑर्डर्स के अनुसार कोई भी अगर मीडिया में इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया में कोई भी अगर एडवर्टीजमेंट आती है तो उसका प्री सर्टिफिकेशन होना जरूरी है.